I need your help with refrigerator compressor troubleshooting.
The compressor, along with the control board, is one of the most expensive parts on the refrigerator.
That's why I want to know what is wrong before I pay someone to replace the whole thing.
If the compressor clicks or flips but does not always start, you probably only need to replace the start relay, not the whole compressor.
That's like the starter cap kits for air conditioners.
The problem might be a thermostatic switch instead of a start relay, but that too is cheaper to install and maybe even a do-it-yourself task.
What do I do if I'm down to the compressor being the problem?
Break out an ohm meter, apply the ohm meter to the start relay's pins and see if you get an OL reading on the meter. If so, the compressor is bad and needs to be replaced.
There are several pins, like the run, common and start winding pins. Which one do I test?
If any of them give you a reading of OL, replace the whole thing. You can get shorts in the compressor motor, whether a turn-to-turn winding short or winding to frame short.
This explanation is running too long.
If any windings have lower readings than the other, the compressor needs to be replaced.
Readings can vary. How low is too low?
The readings like between run and common pins should be within half an ohm. More variation than that is bad and means something is bad.
You also said it could be something else.
Sure, and that's likely if the motor windings are fine. Unfortunately, motor starting relays are a lot harder to replace on a fridge than on an AC.
So what do I do?
Check the continuity on the thermostatic control switch, which should have zero readings between the plug sides and a wire on the start relay. If it says OL, then the thermostatic control is bad.
And if it is not bad, then I know it is the starting relay.
If all the electrical stuff is fine or still doesn't work after you replace electrical components, you could still have bad bearings or valves.
If in doubt, reboot.
We're talking about a motor and relays and switches. Why reboot it?
If there are wiring problems and switched out components, it might not come back on right until you reboot the control panel by power cycling it.
That should happen when you plug it back in, since you should have turned it off before working on it. If you hadn't, that'd be quite a shock.
You don't think I'm safety-oriented?
No, you'd literally get shocked working on it without unplugging it.